inventory on your disposal. If you're not used to doing things like this, what you would expect is that you will have your new item, look through it, remove your old item, whatever it may be. At that point, you'll be able to look at the one and the other and expect then that you will need to go to the store. So you always want to do this at a time when you will, after you've been able to remove the old item, you'll be able to go to the store because you will probably need something. I'll be surprised if we don't. I tried to bring everything we might need. Here's our new cord. Oh, look, it came with little wire nuts. How handy is that? It appears that we are going to need to connect the power cord to the disposal. Okay, this is a new Disposer throat and stopper. It's essentially the same as the one we just removed. So if it was your own house and you didn't really feel like changing it, you could probably have left this in and just hooked up the new disposer. This is the beginning part of our trap, which we will connect. Instructions, always important. And our new disposer. And it looks like that is all that's in the box. So it's going to be a good thing that we saved our old trap and that the trap was in good shape. At this point, if it was not, we'd be running to the store.
Okay.
Can you see me? One thing we didn't talk about is checking the dimensions of the new disposer. We need to make sure that our drain is going to make pitch, okay? Now, we had an existing one installed, so this makes it a little bit easier than normal. All we're gonna do, we're gonna take a look at the old disposer and measure where its outlet is in comparison to where it connects to the sink, and then we'll measure the new one. It looks to me, just by eye,
like a little trick.
One of the things that we do, if you set this up there, now you can measure directly, exactly from center to the bottom. And it's actually a little shorter than that. It's about 5 7/8. So that's the old one. Now if the new one's anywhere close, we'll be fine. So let's do the same thing. Set it up there. Measure on center. That's our center there. I think it's hard to tell. Okay, there, that's center. And it's exactly the same. It's 5 7/8. So what we're gonna do now is connect the electrical cord. In this video, I'm assuming you have the electrical in for the connection and that it is correct. If you are putting in electric, I'll be doing another video, I'm sure, on that at some point, but you need to look up how to run your electric, and you need to look at the specs on your disposer, how many amps, etc., etc. And it should be on a dedicated circuit, usually with...
Follow all the recommendations from the manufacturer.
This one had a plug, so we had to go buy a separate plug. This doesn't normally come with it, which we have, and we're going to put it into the disposer now. That Phillips screwdriver that I mentioned. Okay, came in handy there. Now we're going to, you can see the hole, we're going to feed these through. Into the hole. This little one with the circle on it will be our ground, and that I know will go onto the green. What I'm not seeing are the leads. Oh, there they are. On.
once you get it loosened up, be careful and keep your fingers on it because you don't want to drop the screw into the disposer. Now we put it through that hole and we're going to thread it back in. Again, do it by hand at first because your hand can feel better. Be careful as you put it in, you never want to force it. If it's hard going at the beginning, back it off and try again, because if you force it, you've probably cross-threaded it. And it should turn easily. If it doesn't, back it off and try it again until you get it to turn nice and easy, because you don't want to cross-thread it. Once you do that, you're out of luck. You're going to have to get a new screw or something. Okay, so our ground is on. Okay. Now these, I do not see any appreciable difference on. Let's see what our instructions say. Okay. It's suggesting that we put our strain relief in there first. You'll see there's two slots here and there's two sort of rubber things that line up with those. So we're going to go ahead and try and get this in there. They're suggesting to us that this is much easier if we heat it with a hair dryer, but I don't have a hair dryer, so we're going to see just how tough this really is. We're not kidding. So what we're going to do is get it in, get it going pretty well so that it's started. And once again, we'll use our trusty hammer. Okay. So, the first thing I did is I removed that ground screw because obviously we're going to have to manhandle this and we don't want to be breaking that little wire off or we'll be running to the store for a new cord. I went out to the truck, to my handy bag of tricks, and got, what do they call this? They call it waterproof grease. Basically, it's silicone. Don't use plumbers, don't use dope. Remember we talked about that? That would also make it slippery. But what this comes in various forms. It's also called, there's also one called lube tube. But basically, it's a silicone grease, which is safe to use with plastics and rubbers. I'm going to put that on there. And we'll see if that helps it out any. Because this is pretty. All right, now. This is the only way that we're going to get a good seal for the electric. We have to get it in there. We're going to see if we can borrow a hairdryer. Okay, so we're going to try this hairdryer thing. It says in the instructions. There's always something. This is our something today. Love is sweet misery. pulled off. I got one side in. I'm going to try and leave that in. And reheat the other side. Starting to get it. Here's what I'm doing. The whole beating thing didn't work out for me. Usually beating things is a pretty good plan. It's catching, this metal edge isn't finished and it's got like a sharp edge and it's catching that rubber. And so what I'm doing is I have the one side that I got in and I'm kind of pushing the rubber in and down. I started as close to the side that I had down as I could and now I'm working my way around. I will continue to work my way around, but I'm going to save tape and video and stop this right now while I finish this up, because I obviously have a plan that works now, and I'll be back.